brother. He's been on My Wife and Kids. He's a cast member on Wildin' Out. And y'all know him as Money Mike. Put your hands together for Cat Williams!
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. What a pleasure to be here. So beautiful. I'm just here to remind niggas that life is short. You gotta enjoy your motherfucking life. Enjoy your goddamn life. Stop being ungrateful all the goddamn time. You gotta be happy about your motherfucking life. If God done bless you with a Chrysler 300, nigga, stop talking shit. Walking around telling niggas, yeah, nigga, the reason I got it, nigga, is because it looked like a Phantom. No, nigga, it looked like a Chrysler 300. The fucked up part is that bitch do look like a Phantom until a Phantom pull up. Then you just act the light. Just... this is bullshit. I don't even want to be on this street, nigga. I don't even want to be on this street. I'm saying you gotta be happy about your motherfucking life. I know 50 Cent done made it real cool to be shot. Let me just say something. Niggas, you can't be hard all the motherfucking time. We all know niggas is hard too often. 7 o'clock in the goddamn morning, these niggas hard. Wait a minute, niggas, you angry at breakfast, nigga? You gangbanging on bacon, nigga, you? I know 50 done made it cool to be shot. I've been shot before. Ain't shit cool about it. When I got shot, ain't no music play. Ain't no bitches come out. Nothing. The fucked up part is when I got shot, I wasn't even in an altercation. I'm outside the club watching some other niggas. I'm like, look at these crazy ass niggas. Oh, these niggas finna fight. Oh, that nigga got a gun. It's finna get good. Bam! Wait a minute, Jesus! Pimp down! 1032, bitch! Get the trunk! This is bullshit. I done got blood in my perm, nigga. I'm finna black out. I'm just saying, life is short. Ladies, y'all need to stop stressing all the motherfucking time. You need to understand, bitch, if you are not the shit to you, you are not the shit to any fucking body else. You need to understand that and just deal with it. We are tired of y'all getting in relationships with us and blaming us for shit we ain't even in control of. You done got with a nigga, you talking about, well, you fucked up my self-esteem. Bitch, it's called self-esteem. It's esteem of your motherfucking self, bitch. How the fuck did I fuck up how you feel about you? And don't get mad because I'm calling you bitches. I'm only calling you bitches because I don't know your names individually. Shamananaya. I'm just saying, ladies, you gotta be the shit to you, ladies. You gotta be the shit to you. Some of y'all stress entirely too fucking much about shit that niggas don't even care about. Never in the history of niggerdom has a nigga been getting ready to fuck a woman and change his mind because her fingernails and toenails didn't match. Not once. Not never. Never has a nigga been putting a condom on and went, bitch, is that plum and red? I can't even do it, bitch. I can't even do it. I'm out of here. Not once. Not once. Y'all be worried about shit don't even matter. Some of y'all done had some kids. Now you got some stretch marks. You walking around the house bitter, blaming the baby, showing the baby your high school picture. Look what you did to me. Ladies, if your man got a stretch mark, is mad about your stretch marks, I suggest that you stop fucking with bitch niggas. I think I speak for all real niggas in attendance when I say we don't have time to worry about no simple shit like stretch marks. Bitch, we know they either came from one of two things. Either you was big and got small, or you was small and got big. Either way, we fucking. Either way. Life is too short. All the fuck I'm saying. Ladies, you gotta start taking some responsibility for your own miserable life. If you over 25 years old, you still walking around here talking about niggas ain't shit, bitch, you need to grow the fuck up with your irresponsible ass. What you meant to say was all the niggas you fuck with ain't shit. That's right. You need to figure out what it is about your pussy that keep attracting ain't shit niggas. Might be ain't shit pussy. Just saying, life is short. That's all I'm saying. You gotta enjoy your motherfucking life. That's all I'm saying. If we didn't learn shit from Louisiana, we learned you gotta be happy about whatever the fuck you got right now. You don't know what the fuck may happen. That Louisiana shit, that shit changed my whole fucking life. I ain't never seen nothing that goddamn sad. This gangster niggas in L.A., them niggas in Louisiana was gangster than a motherfucker. You can be gangster in good weather. These niggas was gangster in 99 feet of motherfucking water. Nigga, how is you swimming and keeping your pistol out the water at the same time? Nigga. If that ain't some gangster shit, y'all been all that. I'm Cat. Thank you so much.
Epstein's probably the first person that I ever looked at a photograph of and was like, yeah, he rapes. Not sure this motherfucker has a choice. Not a handsome man. Not a lot of meat and extra skin on his face. Yeah, he's ugly. You know the sad part is, he's done so well in life, he probably doesn't know he's ugly. You know, when you're good looking, everybody will tell you, oh, you look wonderful, you're so great looking. But when you're ugly, you gotta figure that shit out for yourself. It's a lot of putting clues together through the ears. Why am I not getting in the club? I got all the right shit on. If it was Brad Pitt doing that shit, he wouldn't hurt a peep. The girl would just come back down like, I got the part. Yuck. And yet, it is important that I acknowledge, ladies, you are absolutely right. There you go. And you gotta all be mindful of that, guys, because this could happen to any of us. It could happen to me. I can see that. I can see myself showing up. Hi, I'm here for my 3 a.m. with Mr. Weinstein. Hey, Harvey, I got your text. I'm here to talk about the script. Seems like it's going to be hard to read in candlelight, but I guess I could try. Sound like a fucking nightmare. Could you imagine that shit? Could you imagine if you was in a business meeting and a motherfucker pulled their dick out? In the middle of the meeting, I'd be like, yo, my man, this is the most unprofessional shit I've ever seen in all my days.
Just let me finish, Dave Chappelle. I'll put you in all three Lord of the Rings.
Hurry up, nigga. I have other meetings, you know. I have a 4:30 a.m. at Brett Ratner's house. I believe it's wardrobe fitting.